Thank you so much. Is there a retirement going on over there? Is that what's happening? Retirement? Yeah, congratulations. Yay. We were going to play Happy Birthday, and then someone said, no, it's a retirement. So we might play Happy Birthday anyway, and then you could sing Happy Retirement to you. Maybe?
Or when I'm 60.
Well, thank you. We're the Brass Knuckles. We're from the Madison area. We're so excited to be back here. It's our second gig here. The first tune was a medley of swing tunes that were popular in the 90s and from the West Coast. And we just love playing that tune. The next tune is a rag tune called 12th Street Rag. Thank you. Thank you so much. Great. So great to see so many people here. How's the food? Food? Nice. We're poor musicians, so feel free to share.
Well, don't throw it at the stage.
We'll take leftovers even. Okay, so this is Jazz Night, and we do a variety of jazz. You know, the first one was swing. This one, this last one was a ragtime. And this next one is really, it's by Tito Puente, and it's a straight jazz, but it's really a lot of fun. You'll recognize it as soon as we get going. Thank you so much. Feel free to dance. Dancing is acceptable. Dancing is very acceptable. All right, we're going to keep in the little Latin groove now. We're going to do Besame Mucho.
Last time she was here, she said it's okay to not make it sound good. So good evening, and thank you all for coming out. Hope you're enjoying this. We're going to take a few minutes here, just let these guys' lips rest. But in a minute, we're going to come back and play a tune from one of the most famous composers in American jazz history, Duke Ellington. And I think most of you know the tune, but the name of it is "It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing." Thank you.
Next, we're going to stay in the jazz standards world. And I'm too lazy to move the microphone, so this one is from... What musical is this from? Two for the Show, Hamilton and Lewis. Well known as a jazz standard, arranged by Lenny Niehaus, who did a lot of jazz arranging. How High the Moon.
Thank you so much. Most people, when they think of a brass group, they don't think, oh, jazz. But I think we're doing okay. We love to play jazz. Most of us play in orchestras and jazz ensembles and salsa groups and all kinds of stuff. So we can get around the genres pretty well. As a matter of fact, the next tune we're going to do for you is a Beatles tune.
It's still a jazz tune.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Someone threw a tip in here. Thank you so much. There were several $100 bills. Thank you. We really appreciate that. Feel free, if you know the tunes too, if you know the words, sing along. Anything, you know? Come up, come on. There's a little dance floor down here. Don't be shy. But the next tune we're going to do, by the way, we do have a Facebook page, Brass Knuckles Brass Quintet with Percussion. We'd appreciate it if you could go there, like us, follow us. We have other gigs coming up, of course. So it'd be great to see you at some other things. The next tune is by Stephen Sondheim, and it's from a musical called Follies. And it's called Broadway Baby.
Thank you. Try that one again, please.
No, we might do it later.
I'd like a second shot.
We're taking Stardust out of here.
All right, now an old jazz standard by Hoagie Carmichael called Stardust. Hey, nice hat, by the way. Well, I know that you're all very cultured and very intelligent, and you know the name Henry Mancini, right?
Yes.
Henry Mancini? Wonderful movie music composer. I grew up on listening to a lot of his stuff, Peter Gunn, all that kind of thing. This tune you'll certainly recognize. He wrote this, and it was used in a couple of movies with an Inspector Clouseau. And I remember watching those movies as a kid, and they were just hilarious. And then, also, it was used for a cartoon. So as a kid on Saturday morning, I used to watch this cartoon. So we hope you enjoy the Pink Panther.
Mm-hmm.
So much. I know all of us are featured at some point throughout the night, many points throughout the night, but Carl was doing some nice soloing on that one, on the tuba there. Way to go, Carl. Yeah. All right, we're going to play two more tunes and then take a little break. Jim's going to give you a clean version introduction of this particular piece. We have the clean version tonight.
That was a hint. All right, well, this tune was done in the mid-60s by a group called The Animals. And it's about a house somewhere, okay, I'll keep it clean. Somewhere down south, it may have blown away. Many people have been there. It's called The House of the Rising Sun.
Yeah.
Oh, you like that one, eh? Thank you so much. Again, we have a Facebook page, the Brass Knuckles Brass Quintet with Percussion. Please like and follow us. We'd really like to see you there. All right, we're going to take just a minute here to get ready for the for our last tune of this set. It's by Stephanie Germanata, which I'm sure you all know that name. And you'll recognize the tune once we get going. And then we're going to take a little break, and then we'll be back. By the way, this is the best one because it features me at the beginning. Trumpet there. Nice job, TJ. Of course, that was Amazing Grace. That's a for those of you that are familiar with brass quintet music, a lot of the arrangements we do are by arrangers and writers for the Canadian brass, which are kind of heroes of ours. There's some other ones out there too, but Canadian brass is like the epitome of showmanship and that great playing. So before I forget, we need to say to Julian and Eli, thank you so much for having us back again for the second time. And I think these guys have done such a great, These guys have done such a great job making this place happen. I mean, it's just, who'd have thought Lake Mills, Wisconsin, you can come and hear music and eat great food and hang out and just have a good time. And the beer is really good too. I haven't had one yet, but I will be. So, and I know that we're live streaming right now, so I know that you live stream every show, right, Eli? Everything, every time? Yep. So if you can't make it to a show physically, make sure that you check out the live streams. But if you can get here, we'd love to see more people here at all the shows. And it's a great place to be. And I see we have some regulars here from the last time we were, so we appreciate that. The next tune we're going to do for you is by Spencer Williams. And again, it's another Canadian brass arrangement. And it's called Basin Street Blues. Thank you. That one has a lot of high notes. Woo. So yay for all of us. And Jim had some really high notes on the drums. Ooh. Are you going to be okay?
Yeah, I'm going to be.
All right. High hats, huh? All right, just give us a moment here.
Well, this next tune that we're going to play for you is from the composer Vince Guaraldi. Most of you know it from a famous TV show that came on every holiday, sometime between Thanksgiving and Christmas. And somebody was trying to kick a football, and some mean little girl kept taking that football away from him as he kicked it. So maybe you guys can help us out with this. A little bit of Linus and Lucy.
You know, I didn't see any food scraps come up here for us. Did you? Did you guys get any?
I ate them all.
You ate them all?
I ate
them all, yeah. Oh. All right. Well, thanks whoever donated those. You know, we played at Old World, Wisconsin all first 3 weekends in December, all day Saturday, all day Sunday for like, I don't know, 6-8 hours or something like that. And at Old World, Wisconsin, they have a place where you can get some wassail. You can get the, you know, kiddie version or the adult version. And we like the adult version, of course. And every time we do concerts there, I always say, hey, you know, if you go down there and you get some wassail, you know, please, you know, if you'd like to, you could certainly donate some to us. And all the years we've played there, nobody's ever done it until this year, this last year. Someone came and brought us all wassail, the adult version, and it was yummy. And we couldn't finish the day. We were... No, it actually helped us. It helped us. I think it had bourbon in it, I believe, didn't it? Yeah, bourbon? Yeah. Okay, this next tune features me.
He's got to he's got to empty that horn after all that. Next, we shall proceed to another jazz standard. This one is by Bart Howard, which I probably couldn't have told you, even though I've played and sung this song 8,000 times. But it can be done in 4/4 or in 3/4 as a waltz. And we will do both in this arrangement. Though I don't recommend singing it as a waltz because it sounds really dumb. So sing it in 4/4, instrumentalize it in waltz. Fly Me to the Moon.
Yes, we have to state that one of our members tonight has subbed with us before, but not very often, and all of this music tonight is new to him. He was given it about a month ago and said, please learn this, and he's done just a great job. It's not easy music. It's tough, and that's Mike Berger on trumpet over there. So. Our other trumpet player had to bow out of the group as an emergency, and so we were running around trying to find substitutes when we played at Old World, and I think we had 3 different trumpet substitutes within 1 day or 2 days. It was crazy. But we got it worked out, and we're actually looking for a new trumpet player, and Mike's on the list of people that are auditioning, so this is like his audition. Right? So what do you think? How did he do? How's he doing? All right, now.
We can put the comments on the resume, right? This.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Are we going to give Mike a rose?
The Bachelor.
It's on record.
The Trumpet. Oh. It could be a TV show, The Trumpet.
Yeah.
Yeah. The next tune was made famous by Nat King Cole. Was anybody dancing? I didn't see. Liar. All right, the next tune is from a movie. And there's been several, you know, part two, part three, part four of these. And it's composed by Randy Newman, who's a great composer, writes all kinds of stuff. But you'll recognize as soon as we get going. No, it's not Star Wars. That's John Williams.
Thank you.
Okay, so what's that one called? What's it called? You've Got a Friend in Me. Very good. And what movie is it from?
The Grinch Stole Christmas.
Not The Grinch That Stole Christmas. What was it from? Somebody said over here. Toy Story. Very good.
One, two, three, or four?
All of them?
The first one.
First one. All right, how about some Chicago?
Third one's in Spanish.
Oh, okay. Okay. This is Easter Bunny.
Thank you.
I was really lucky. I saw Earth, Wind & Fire and Chicago in concert like 10 or 15 years ago. Dynamite concert. Oh, my gosh. What? That was 10 or 15 years ago. What are you talking about? Hey, man, you're retired. I'm not retired.
I mean, we're tired.
Well, we're tired, but not retired, yes. Little Tom Cook over there. You guys are playing here in 2 weeks, right? Tweaks? Twix. And what's the name of the group?
Tapestry.
2 weeks from tonight. It's going to be dynamite.
My face is tired.
Tom is a trombone player, Tom, but we won't hold it against him.
Yeah. I'm tired. Do you want to just...
Roger, you can play. I sold that thing. Where was I?
The last one sounded high. All right, we're going to do one more tune in this set. Then we're going to take a little break. Not some more Beatles, a little more Beatles on All You Need Is Love.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We really like that one. That one's called Killer Tango. Again, another Canadian Brass arrangement, as well as the next one. I remember the first time I saw the Canadian Brass, I think it was at the Oscar Mayer Theater in Madison, which doesn't exist anymore. But no one was on stage, and they started to play, and they walked through the audience, and they played this piece, and they walked up to the stage, and when they got to the fast part, they got up there, and it was just really so exciting, you know, to be an undergraduate student and hearing that wonderful kind of music. So, just a closer walk with thee.
Mm-hmm.
Something completely different you would never think of brass quintet. So far, I mean, you've heard Lady Gaga, the Beatles, all kinds of stuff you never thought that you heard would hear a brass quintet play. It's the kind of music you don't typically think of. You think of, you know, like, I don't know, Renaissance music and hoity-toity classical stuff. But now we're going to do some Coldplay.
Thank you.
look, another $100 bill in the tip jar. Awesome. Thank you. Thank you. Free bird?
Free bird!
No. How about a little Scott Joplin? Scott Joplin.
It's kind of like Free Bird. Same notes.
We'll call it the Free Bird Rap.
Just in a different arrangement. There besides Tom. Well, we can't really count Tom as a brass player because he plays trombone. But how many of you out there play or have played a brass instrument sometime in your life? Okay. So sorry. Yeah. There's therapy.
All right. Did you play, really? Or for like a week? You played for a week? So you are, those of you that have played brass instruments are feeling our pain a little bit right now, right? Just a little bit. We're going almost, we're on 2.5 hours now. Oh, we do. Are we stopping? No. Okay. All right, how about a little, let's see, I remember this, Tony Orlando and Dawn. Anybody remember those guys? The velvet, crushed velvet lapels and the bow tie. Yeah, and the mustache. I did wear a crushed velvet tuxedo. I did, and I wore it with pride. Oh, I can tell you're brass players. Okay, here we go.
Mm.
The second page of this piece?
Probably.
Spiritually, he does.
Well, it changes key.
Yes, and let's get that change of key today.
You know,
at 51.
So you should be fine.
Oh, I'm gonna. It's all good.
Why do you have 2 pages?
A little Earth, Wind, and Fire. It's January, but, you know, September, we can play that anytime, can't we?
Yeah.
It's not terribly cold. I have to tell you that I went to Palm Springs, California, for right after Christmas, for a little over a week, just when it got really cold here, like frigid cold and snow. So it was fun, and it was nice. We sat by the pool, had some margaritas. It was very nice.
Rub it in.
While you froze to death, and I don't care.
Thanks, Craig. And now we're going to kill out this chop. You won't care about that either. It's going to be fun.
This next tune features Alex. By the way, our drummer, Jim Latimer, on most of this music, almost all but I think like two or three charts, he has no music. And so he's a great musician. He and I have been making music together since we were like, I don't know, 12 or 13 in a variety of ways. He just has a real good feel for just playing really good music, and he can feel the phrasing, and he doesn't have any music, and he just does a great job. So let's hear it for our drummer, Jim. What do you do by day, Jim?
Hmm?
What do you do during the daytime to make a living?
I take my music home and memorize it. So
no, you don't. No, you don't.
Good answer.
Aren't you in construction or something?
Yeah, I do a little bit of masonry.
Masonry, yeah. And construction and stuff. Yeah, so.
Great dream.
All right, we're going to do a piece now that combines two different pieces, and they don't think like they, when you hear it, it shouldn't make sense.
But don't try this at home.
Yeah, don't, because it's dangerous. But it's When the Saints Go Marching In and the Alleluia Chorus. It works.
Thank you.
Trombone for a week, so you want to sit in? Okay. That's a fun one. And again, it doesn't seem like it should work, but it does. You know, that what great arranging, you know? Canadian Brass have some great arrangers and composers. Are you going to make it? Are you going to make it to the end? You going to be all right, Alex?
How close the end is.
It's about 20 minutes away. You can do it. You can do it.
You're the man.
Have a drink of beer. You'll be fine. Or I can do a little Quincy Jones here. This tune, I think they did this tune in, what was that movie?
Austin Powers.
What was it? Austin Powers?
Powers?
Yeah? Burt Bacharach. No, it's not by Burt Bacharach. Quincy Jones. Thank you. Well, I thank you. And thank you for all the tips. My goodness, the tip jar is getting full. Nice. All right, we're going to do a tune that has nothing to do with jazz.
But it's still fun.
But it's still fun. Give us a minute to find it.
Don't worry, you have a solo.
All right. This tune is a klezmer tune, and so it makes you want to move and dance and clap and stomp. So please feel free. It's called As Camels Dance. And it's an old Byzantine folk tune. Because we do everything on iPad or, you know, tablets now, sometimes our music doesn't cooperate and doesn't show up on our screen. So just give us a moment. All right, so we're going to repeat a couple of things we did earlier tonight. This tune, if you didn't hear it earlier, it's called Jump Swing Fever. It's a medley of Jump, Jive, and Wail, Zoot Suit Riot, and You and Me, made popular in the 90s from the West Coast Swing movement. Thank you for those of you that stayed and our diehards. We really appreciate it. Yes? We have time for, I think, two more tunes. And again, what?
Six.
One?
Six.
Seven?
Ten.
Oh.
We can do this all night.
Again, thanks to the pyramid. This has been great. A little Tito Puente. Thank you so much. It's been great. Hopefully we can come back again someday and play. But in the meantime, check out the live streams. Come here if you can. Support live music all that you can. Support local businesses like this one is doing a fantastic job. And we're going to end with a little Duke Ellington. Thank you.
the book of 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 the book of